بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنام وخاتم النبيين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد، فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتاب العزيز بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. فقال الله سبحانه وتعالى: لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل في ضلال مبين. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: آتي باب الجنة فأستفتح، فيقول الخازن: من أنت؟ فأقول: أنا محمد. فيقول الخازن: بك أمرت أن لا أفتح لأحد قبلك. رواه الترمذي، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. My respected brothers and elders and respected scholars and fellow youngsters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We are very fortunate to be from this ummah, where our ears are able to hear the children of this ummah recite the Quran in front of us. No ummah has this honor, where the children of this ummah memorize the book of this ummah and they recite this Quran to the ummah. And this Qur'an is very special. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals it. And He says, تَنْزِيلٌ مِمَّنْ خَلَقَ الْأَرْضَ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ الْعُلَى. This Qur'an was revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الرَّحْمَنُ عَلَى الْعَرْشِ اسْتَوَى. Who is above everything in the world. وَخَلَقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. Allah created every single thing in the world. So this Qur'an is from Allah, كَلَامُ اللَّهِ. Revealed through the biggest and the greatest angels. تَنْزِيلٌ مِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. This is revelation that's coming from Allah, from heavens. نَزَلَ بِهِ رُوحُ الْأَمِينَ. Via the greatest angel, Jibreel عليه السلام. نَزَلَ بِهِ رُوحُ الْأَمِينَ. سبحان الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Naba, رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما الرحمن لا يملكون منه خطابا يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة تصف الله. On the day of judgment, everyone will be silent and no one will speak. Out of all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah in this ayah, يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة. You know, خاص العموم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make all the angels stand in front. But Allah mentioned Ruh al-Amin here. Imam Qurtubi and Fakhr al-Razi say, why Ruh al-Amin? Because of the greatest creations of Allah is Jibreel. Even the greatest creation of Allah on the Day of Judgment will be silent. This is the greatest creation. نَزَلَ بِهِ رُوحُ الْأَمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, above Ruh al-Amin, فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالْخُنَّسِ الْجَوَارِ الْكُنَّسِ وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا عَسْعَسِ والصبح إذا تنفس إنه لقول رسول كريم. A messenger who is Jibreel, his voice is honored in the eyes of Allah. ذي قوة عند ذي العرش مكين. Who is very strong in his memory and very honored and respected in the eyes of Allah. ذي قوة عند ذي العرش مكين. مطاع and obedient to Allah. You know, when you have a messenger, you want the messenger to be obedient. مُطَاعٍ ثَمَّ أَمِينٍ. Anyone have a Nissan Altima? What year? What color?
Silver.
Silver? Anyone have a Nissan Altima silver? Please move the car, you're blocking the way.
Also the Lincoln Navigator, a Lincoln GTU 6565.
Anyone blocking any car, please go and move the car for the next reference. مُطَاعٍ ثَمَّ أَمِينٍ. The angel is an angel that obeys the command of Allah. One day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Jibreel, Ya Jibreel, هَلْ رَأَيْتَ رَبَّكَ. Have you seen Allah? Have you seen Allah? فَانْتَفَضَ Jibreel. Jibreel, who is the closest to Allah, one of the closest angels, he started to shake. Started to shake. فَانْتَفَضَ. He has 600 wings. سِتَّ مِيَةَ جَنَاح. 600 wings. One covers the east, one covers the west. So powerful. He says, Allah's Rasul is asking, هَلْ رَأَيْتَ رَبَّكَ. Have you seen your Lord? Jibreel starts to shake. فَقَالْ إِنَّ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَهُ سَبْعُونَ حِجَابًا سَبْعِينَ حِجَابًا مِّن نُورٍ لَوْ دَنَوْتُهُ مِنْ بَعْلَ احْتَرَقْتُهُ. So between me and Allah, there are 70 پردہ زب نور. میرے اللہ کے درمیان 70 پردے ہیں نور کے, 70. لو جنوت من بعد لاحترقت. And if I was to come one inch close, I would blaze into fire because of the nur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اگر میں قریب آتا اللہ کے نور کی تجلی مجھے جلا دیتی. Allah, can you imagine how powerful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is? مُطَاعٍ ثَمَّ أَمِينٍ. And very honored in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the greatest kalam, Allah, Allah, the greatest, Allahu Akbar. And the greatest angel, Jibreel, عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُنْزِرِينَ. سب سے اونچا اللہ اور سب سے اونچا ملک فرشتہ جبریل اور سب سے اونچا انسان شخصیت محمد رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ, اور سب سے اونچی جگہ رسول صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کی مبارک زندگی میں جسم میں دل. Allah is saying in the Quran, عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ. We're not revealing this Quran to your brain. ہم دماغ میں نہیں اتار رہے. على قلبك لتكون من المنذرين. اللہ اکبر. ہم یہ قرآن آسمان سے جبریل کے راستے سے تمہارے دل میں اتار رہے. على قلبك لتكون من المنذرين. اور آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم جب when he would memorize the Quran and he would repeat it. اللہ سبحانہ وتعالی سے رسول صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, لا تحرک به لسانك لتعجل به ان علينا جمعه وقرآنا. لا الہ الا اللہ. جب قرآن, when the Quran is being revealed to you, Ya Rasulullah, don't worry about memorizing it. Don't move your lips. I will bring the Quran into your hearts. Such Quran that we heard today, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. If this Quran was revealed onto mountains, the mountains will become into dirt. If it was going to be revealed on mountains. Can you imagine the strength of the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The strength of the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ruhani taqat kya hogi aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki? Ki Allah asman se Quran ke dil mein utar rahe. What will be the spiritual level of the Prophet's heart that the mountains could not bear the Quran, but the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam took the Quran directly? Kya? La ilaha illallah. اور صحابہ کی کیا شان ہوگی. And what would be the enjoyment of the صحابہ? They used to hear the Prophet recite the Quran in salah. لا الہ الا اللہ, لا الہ الا اللہ, على قلبك لتكون من المنذرين. And in the greatest language, بلسان عربي مبين, إنا أنزلناه قرآنا عربيا لعلكم تعقلون. The greatest of all, Allahu Akbar. To the greatest of angels, Jibreel. To the greatest of humans, Muhammad. To the greatest of physicians is heart. To the greatest of languages, لسان عربي مبين. To the greatest of ummah, the ummah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. This is the ummah. All the stories of the previous ummah. سارے امتوں کے قصص اور سارے امتوں کے واقعات, سارے امت کی مثال اللہ نے قرآن میں جمع کی ہے اس امت کو سمجھانے کے لئے. لا الہ الا اللہ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gathered all the stories. Adam, look at Adam. اسکن انت وزوجك الجنة. دیکھو کیا ہوا آدم کے ساتھ. وذکر فی الکتاب اسماعیل وذکر فی الکتاب ادریس. اور ذکر کرو ادریس اور اسماعیل کے قصے. The whole Quran is full with this. Surah Hud, Surah Ibrahim, Surah Yusuf. نحن نقص عليك احسن القصص بما اوحينا الیک هذا القرآن. All of this, why? Why? Allah, یہ سب سارے قصے کیوں جمع کر رہے ہیں؟ اس امت کو سمجھانے کے لیے. To explain Allah gathering all these stories, all these آیات and احکام and examples in the Quran. Why is he doing this? So this ummah, who is the greatest ummah, has no excuse to leave the direction of Sirat al-Mustaqim. The ummah knows where to go. If you're rich and you like business, watch out. This is Shu'aib alayhi salam's ummah. If you like power, look at Fir'aun and Qarun. Look at all this life. If you like beauty, look at what happened to Yusuf and his people. So brothers and elders and scholars, we are the most fortunate ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ala qalbik, this is Rasulullah. Imam Idris, Mawlana Idris Kandalwi rahmatullah alayhi, has said in the Sirat al-Mustafa, the heart of the Prophet ﷺ physically was opened four times. Shaq al-Sadr. Once in the house of Halima Sa'diyah. Dil Absa Sadr, char the fur kula. Allahu Akbar. Once in the house of Halima Sa'diyah. Then he says, once when he was 12 years old, before the adolescence, Jawani se pehle. Us Jawani ko rang ko utarna. Then, qabl al-Nubuwa, Nubuwa se pehle. تاکہ نوح روحانی تجلی کے لیے اور کلام کے لیے یہ دل تیار ہو. لا الہ الا اللہ. So the heart could be ready for revelation. And then the fourth, before Isra Mi'raj. Before the journey of Mi'raj. And this is Rajab. Brothers and elders, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the greatest human ever. Greatest human. أنس رضي الله عنه says, ما مسست ديباجا ولا حريرا ألين من كف رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I did not touch any hands, I did not touch any silk or any cloth softer than the hands of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. وما شممت راحية أطيب من راحية رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I did not smell any fragrance as many كبيرة في خشبوني سنجي جو آف صلى الله عليه وسلم كي مبارك جسم تنكل دي. I did not smell any fragrance which was more beautiful than the fragrance that would come naturally off the body of the Prophet ﷺ. Hands. Hands. His ishara. One day the Prophet ﷺ is sitting. A Bedouin ja'a Arabiyun. A Bedouin comes. Baddu. The Prophet ﷺ, halaka bi khayran. Shall I not give you something good? Islam. So the Bedouin says, man tajhad. Who is going to say you are a prophet? Who believes in you? You're telling me you're a prophet? How? Give me some evidence. فَقَالَ لَهُ قُلْ لِهَذِي الشَّجَرَةِ. Go there and this درخت کو کہو کہ محمد اس درخت کو بلا رہا ہے. Go to this tree and tell this tree that Muhammad is calling this tree. And the tree فَتْخَضُّ الْأَرْضَ خَضَّى. The tree rips the ground and comes to the Prophet ﷺ. السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. مَنْ أَنَا؟ قال أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأنك رسول الله. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked, who am I? And the tree says, you are the Prophet of Allah. Three times. قال ارجع إلى منبته. Go back to your spot. This was the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. حكم ما مر بحجر ولا شجر إلا قال السلام عليك يا رسول الله. کوئی درخت نہیں گزرا کوئی پتھر نہیں گزرا مگر نیچے گر کے السلام علیکم کہتے تھے. When this Bedouin saw this tree, say assalamu alaikum to the Prophet and greet the Prophet. This Bedouin said, اِذِن لِي أَنْ أَسْجُدَكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. مجھے اجازت دے میں تمہارے سامنے سجدہ کروں. کہا نہیں نہیں نہیں. اگر حکم ہوتا تو میں بیوی کو کہتا خاوند کو سجدہ کریں. آج کل یہ حدیث نہیں آتی جمع سمجھ. If I ordered anyone to do sajda to anyone, I would tell the wife, لَأَمَرْتُ أَحَدٍ أَنْ يَسْجُدَ لِأَحَدٍ لَأَمَرْتُ الْمَرْأَةَ أَنْ تَسْجُدَ لِزَوْجِهَا. If I ordered anyone to do sajda to anyone, I would tell the wife to do sajda to the husband. She sharp me here. Khawan, nek bhi ho. Khawan, nek bhi ho. Fasik ke saamne kaun sa adab hoga. So my brothers and elders of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the greatest human. Umm Ma'bad. She narrates a very interesting story. She says one day, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Hijrah. They're traveling. ومعهم عبد الله بن أريج وعامر بن فهيب. And there's two more people with Abu Bakr and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in Hijra. Hijrat ke safar mein. And they come to this camp, this tent. And they ask this lady, whose name was Umm Ma'bad, do you have any food, any bread, any meat, any milk? فقالت نحن القوم المرمنين مسنتين. We have no food, nothing. We are people that are living in drought. فَرَأَى رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ شَاةً فِي كِسْرِ الْخَيْمَةِ. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saw a small goat, far away, very weak. قَالَ مَا هَذَا يَا أُمِّ مَعْبَدْ. What is this goat? قَالَ يَا رَسُولُ خَلَّفَهَا الْجُهَدْ. This is this one goat remaining, has no energy, no milk, nothing. Weak. فَقَالَ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم أَتَّأْذَنِينِ أَنْ أَحْلُوبَهَا. Give me permission to milk this animal. قَالَتْ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إن رأيت بي حلما فاحلبها. يا رسول الله, if you see there is milk, go ahead. But there is no milk in this. This is a weak goat. فدعاها. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم calls the goat. فمسحها. درعها. The Prophet after صلى الله عليه وسلم اپنے مبارک ہاتھ ان کے تھنوں میں رکھے. فتباجت واشترت. And all of the Prophet ﷺ touched the udders of this animal, all of a sudden milk started to drip. Milk started to drip. فَدَعَى بِإِنَاءٍ. And then the Prophet ﷺ said, bring me a bowl, bring me a vessel. يُرْبِتُ الرَّأْءُسْ. And he filled up the vessel. And he gave Abu Bakr and the people with him. He drank and then he filled it up again. And then he paid and he left. فَجَاءَ أَبُو مَعْبَدٍ. And then the husband Abu Ma'bad, he was gone hunting. He comes home and he sees there's movement happening here. Something happened. Someone came in the desert. He says, did someone come here, Umm Ma'bad? Umm Ma'bad says, Naam, ja'a rajulun mubarakun fi halihi kada wa kada. Ek mood mubarak shakhsiyat aayi thi. Guzar ke nikal di. Mubarakun kada wa kada. This very noble, pious person came. He stopped for a few minutes and then he left. Abu Ma'bad says, Sifidi, I want to hear about him. Tell me a little bit, who is this man? They say, the ulama say, the best description of the Prophet ﷺ was given by this lady, Umm Ma'bad. رَجُلٌ ظَاهِرُ الْوَضَاءَ أَبْلَدُ الْوَجْهِ حَسَنُ الْخَلْقِ لَمْ تَعِبْهُ سَجْلًا وَلَمْ تَزْرِي بِهِ صَعْلًا وَصِيمٌ قَصِيمٌ في عينيه جعج وفي أشفاره وطف وفي عنقه سطع وفي لحيته كثافة. This man whose face was glowing. أتى شخص جسك تهرة سمخرة محمد رسول صلى يتلألأ وجهه تلألأ القمر ليلة البدر. The face of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was shining like the full moon in the sky. Full moon in the sky. One day, the Prophet ﷺ is sitting and a man is looking at the Prophet ﷺ. The Prophet gets up, he moves, this man is looking at the Prophet. He gets up, the man is looking at the Prophet ﷺ. Aap sab jahan bhi uthte hain, ye aadmi dekh raha hai Prophet ﷺ ko. The Prophet ﷺ says to this man, Ma baluka ya fulan? What are you looking at? Why are you looking at me always? The man says, Ya Rasulullah, atamatta'u min nazri ilayk. I'm just enjoying my view. Main is manzar ko dekh raha hu. Aapka chehra. La ilaha illallah. Bas aapka chehra ko. The face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. لو لم تكن له آية مبينة لكان منظره ينبئك بالخبر. He says, if there was no sign of the Prophet not having any other signs, just his face will tell you this was a true Prophet. Anas radiallahu anhu says, لما دخل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المدينة أضاء منها كل شيء. When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم entered into Medina, his face enlightened the entire city of Medina. ولما مات النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أظلم منها كل شيء. When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم passed away, everything was full of darkness. And the famous thing of Hassan bin Thabit, there are two famous things. One is this one, وَحَسَّنَ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَرَقَطْتُ عَيْنِي وَأَجْمَلَ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَلِدَ النِّسَاءُ خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّأً مِنْ كُلِّ عَيْبٍ كَأَنَّكَ قَدْ خُلِقْتَ كَمَا تَشَاءُ. This is a very ma'roof thing. Once Hassan bin Thabit was told by the people of Mecca to make fun of the Prophet ﷺ. And he was before Islam, very great poet. And they told him to stand, and when Muhammad ﷺ walks by, you have to say poetry against the Prophet ﷺ. آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم آئیں گے اور سب کے سامنے آپ نے ان کو ذلیل کرنا ہے اشعار کے ساتھ. اور مجمع جمع ہوا اور حسان نے اپنے ذہن کو تیار کیا کہ میں نے کس انداز سے اور کس اشعار سے اس کس بلاغت کے ساتھ میں نے آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کی بیزتی کرنی. اور انداز حسان بن ثابت is thinking, how can I come with the best poems, the most eloquent lines to mock the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. And the entire Mecca is gathered to see the Prophet give this grace. اور سارا مکہ جمع ہوا ہے اس منظر کو دیکھنے کے لیے اور مذاق بنانے کے لیے. اور جب آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم گزرے, and the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم walks by, Hassan bin Thabit has nothing to say. Nothing to say. And later on he says this poem. لَمَّا رَأَيْتُ أَنْوَارَهُ صَفَعَتْ لما رأيت أنواره سطعت وضعت من خيفتي كفي على بصري خوفا على بصري من حسن سورته فلست أنظره إلا على قدري روح من النور جسم من القمر كحلقة نسجت من الأنجم الزهري. Yeah, because when I saw the Prophet, when the nur of the Prophet hit my eyes, لَمَّا رَيْتُ أَنْوَارَهُ سَطَعَتْ, when the nur of the Prophet hit my face and my eyes, وَضَعْتُ مِنْ خِيْفَتِي كَفِّي عَلَى بَصَرِي, I took my hands and I covered my eyes, خَوْفًا عَلَى بَصَرِي مِنْ حُسْنِ سُورَتِي, not because the Prophet wasn't beautiful, because my eyes were full of najasa and the Prophet's nur was too heavy for my eyes. ऐसे नहीं कि आप सलम खूबसूरत नहीं थे, असल में यह था कि ये आंख नजासत की आंखें हैं और ये चेहरा मुबारक नूरानी है. कैसे ये आंख इस मुबारक चेहरे को देखे, खौफन आंखों की खौफ से आंखें नीचे कर दी. अल्लाह लाइक इन अ डार्क रूम, किसी को एक बंद कमरे में रखें अंधेरी में एक महीने के लिए, फिर उसको सूरज दिखाएं, क्या होगा, आंख खराब हो जाएगी उसकी, ये हालत थी. ला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह, यू कीप समवन इन अ डार्क रूम फॉर वन मंथ एंड देन यू शो हिम द लाइट ऑफ द सन, ही विल बिकम ब्लाइंड ऑलमोस्ट, ही विल गेट पेन इन आईज, दिस इज द आई ऑफ अ सिनर, हाउ कैन यू एंजॉय द फेस ऑफ द प्रॉफेट सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम. वदअतु मिन खीफती खौफन कफी अला बसरी फलस्त अंजुरहु इल्ला अला कदरी, आई जस्ट लुक्ड एट हिम वेरी स्लोली एंड लाइटली, रूहुम मिन अन-नूर, अल्लाहु अकबर, the jism, nurani nura, a body, the soul which is full of nur, ruh nur ki, jismum min al-qamari, and the body perfect like the moon, la ilaha, ka hulyatin nusidat min al-anjum al-zuhri, just a pool like flowers, you put them in a vessel, and you make the flowers beautiful, this was the beauty of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu says in hadith sahih, لو قيل لي أن أطيب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما أطيقته. اگر مجھے کوئی کہتا, if someone told me, please tell me how the Prophet looked, I will never be able to. ما أملأ عيني عدلانا له. I never look at the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم because I was afraid of the nur of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. I don't know. ظاهر الوضاء. This was the face of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. لا إله إلا الله. Allah honored the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. Abu Sa'id Khudri رضي الله عنه يقول: جاء جبريل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. جبريل السلام comes to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. كيف رفع اسمك يا عمر؟ أتدري كيف رفع اسمي؟ Do you know Muhammad how Allah سبحانه وتعالى lifted your name, elevated your son, your name? How did Allah elevate your status? Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم: لا أدري. Allah سبحانه وتعالى. جبريل replies: Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, أَلَّا ذُكِرْتُ إِلَّا ذُكِرْتَ مَعِي, جب بھی میرا نام لیا جائے, اللہ کہتے ہیں جب بھی میرا نام لیا جائے گا تمہارا نام ساتھ لیا جائے گا. Whenever my name is mentioned, your name is mentioned. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. لا إله إلا الله. Can you imagine? So brothers and elders, there's so much you can say about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. ظاهر الوضع أبلغ الوجه حسن الخلق, the best of character and looks, خلق الخلق, لم تعبه سجلا ولم تزري به صعلا, not so big, not so heavy, perfect in looks, وسيم قسيم, beautiful, وسيم and قسيم, فرق بينهما, وسيم is the more you look at someone, the more you want to look at him, جتنا تم اس کو دیکھو گے اتنا اور دیکھنا چاہتے ہو. That was the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Today our wife look at us for 1 minute, they look the other way. ہماری بیوی ہم کو دیکھ کے بہت خلاص دیکھ لیا, بٹ لائٹ بند کر لو. وسیم خوبصورت, قسیم, یو سی ہم فرام اینی ویئر, رائٹ لیفٹ فرنٹ بیک, ہی واز بیوٹیفل, ہر قسم سے خوبصورت. وسیم قسیم فی عینیہ دعج, اینڈ ہز آئیز ہی ہیز سم بیوٹی, وفی اشفاره وطف, اینڈ یہ گنگرالے بال, لمبے بال, وفي صوته صحل, and after some time آواز بھی خوبصورت, his voice was very beautiful, his voice was very good voice. لا إله إلا الله. وفي عنقه سطع, His neck was very long. وفي لحيته كثافة. And a very thick beard. Anwar. Brothers and elders, this Quran was revealed to the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after 5 years, the Muslims were going through suffering in Makkah. Pansai Musliman suffer. Mushakkat, mushakkat, mushakkat. After 5 years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, go to Habsha. Go to Abyssinia, Ethiopia. Go to Abu Ja'far, Uthman. Go to Abu Habsha. In the 6th year, Umar bin Khattab and Hamza both become Muslim. 6th year now. Then, now the non-Muslims, the kuffar of Makkah, mushrikeen of Makkah, are very worried. Umar is a Muslim, Hamza is a Muslim. Islam will spread. Remember this rule. No one can stop the growth of Islam. They can slow it down. But Allah has a promise. يُرِيدُونَ لِيُطْفِيُوا نُورُ اللَّهِ بِأَفْوَاهِمْ وَاللَّهُ مُتِمُّ نُورِهِ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْكَافِرُونَ. They will strategize, they will stop the visas, but Islam is going to spread. قُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلُ. Islam is going, has a wa'd. So Umar رضي الله عنه became Muslim. Ibn Abbas says, مَا ذِلَّ عَزَّنَ اللَّهُ مُنْدُ أَسْلَمَ عُمَر. Umar became Muslim, we could see the elevation of Islam. وَمَا ذِلَّ أَذَلَّنَ اللَّهُ مُنْدُ مَاتَ عُمَر. And we could see the decline of Islam after Umar رضي الله عنه passed away. So in the 7th year, 8th year, 9th year, boycott. Boycott, nobody can marry them. Right? 3 years boycott. No business, no trade, so Muslims are suffering even more. Abu Lahab is from the same family, but Abu Lahab was given a special treatment because he was non-Muslim, so they made it exception for Abu Lahab. But anyone that was from that money, Hashim family was boycotted. They didn't say Muslim or non-Muslim. They boycotted the entire family. Just like they will say to a Muslim country, we don't boycott Muslims, we boycott Syria. We boycott Yemen. And there's exceptions. Like Abu Lahab is the exception. La ilaha illallah. Guess what happens next? After 3 years, how many years? 3 years boycott. Khadija radiallahu anha passes away. Khadija passes away. And after that, Abu Talib passes away. Some scholars say Abu Talib first and Khadija. His wife passes away, and his uncle who gave the Prophet ﷺ service, shelter for 50 years. How many? 50. Because the Prophet ﷺ was the age of eight years old when Abdul Muttalib passed away. From the age of 8 to the age of 48, 49. This is how many years? 40 years. How many years? 40 years. Abu Talib was giving the Prophet some shelter. Before Islam, he was there. And after Islam, he said very clearly, وَاللَّهِ لَنْ يَصِلُوا إِلَيْكَ بِجَمْعِهِمْ حَتَّى أُوَسِّدَ فِي التُّرَابِ دَفِينًا فَأَمْضِي لِأَمْرِكَ مَا عَلَيْكَ غَضًّا وَأَبْصِرْ وَقَرَّ بِذَاكَ مِنْكَ عُيُونًا وَدَعَوْتَنِي وَعَلِمْتُ أَنَّكَ نَاصِحِي مِنْ خَيْرِ الْأَدْيَانِ الْبَرِيَّةِ دِينًا لَوْلَا الْمَلَامَةُ أَوْ حِذَارِي سُبَّةً لَوَجَدْتَنِي سَمْحًا بِذَاكَ مُبِينًا. He said to his uncle, his nephew, if it wasn't for the people of Mecca to make fun of me, I will be the first one to accept your religion. And I swear, as long as I'm alive, no one in Mecca can hurt you. He was not Muslim, did not accept Islam. I'm there to protect you. But when he passed away, the Prophet ﷺ had no external support. Khadiji. And his dakhili support, internal support, was Khadija. And she passed away. And the Prophet ﷺ is broken. Scholars say this is Amul Huzn. This is the Huzn Ghamka Salah. In the same time, the Prophet ﷺ goes to Taif. I need some else to go. In Makkah, I'm not safe because Abu Talib has passed away. And my wife had left this world. And Khadija, 25 years on the right side and the left side of the Prophet ﷺ. One day Aisha made a small comment. One day the sister of Khadija came to Medina. And when the Prophet ﷺ heard the voice of the sister of Khadija, the Prophet said, Khadija, Khadija, Khadija. And Khadija has passed away a long time ago. He says, Ya Rasulullah, إن الله أبدلك خيرا من هذه عجوزة من عجائز قريش. Allah has replaced you with someone better than this old lady that you married from the Quraysh. Look it, I am better than Khadija. Look, why are you remembering Khadija? Why are you remembering Khadija? And many times the Prophet ﷺ would stay quiet. But this time the Prophet didn't stay quiet. فَوَاللَّهِ وَاللَّهِ مَا أَبْدَلَ لِيَ اللَّهُ خَيْرٌ مِنْهَا. I swear by Allah, I have not got anyone as good as Khadija. Khadija ki barabar mein koi nahi hai. فَوَاسَتْنِي بِمَالِهَا وَنَفْسِهَا وَآمَنَتْ بِي إِذْ كَذَبَنِيَ النَّاسِ. She believed in me when no one believes in me. لا إله إلا الله. میرے اوپر ایمان لائے پوری دنیا نے مجھے انکار کیا. وَصَدَّقَتْنِي إِذْ كَذَبَنِيَ النَّاسِ. And she said I was true when everyone said I was a liar. شاعر مجنون. And Khadija said, you are my husband, you are the Nabi of Allah. You are the Nabi of Allah. When Khadija took the Prophet ﷺ and covered her, and Bukhari hadith, زَمِّلُونِي, زَمِّلُونِي يَا Khadija. And the Khadija said, وَاللَّهِ لَنْ يُخْزِيكَ اللَّهُ أَبَدًا. Oh Muhammad, when the revelation, Bali Wahi, the first revelation, Khadija says, وَاللَّهِ لَنْ يُخْزِيكَ اللَّهُ أَبَدًا. Allah aapko kabhi tabah nahi karenge. Allah aapko kabhi ruswa nahi karenge. Allah will never make you fail in life. Allah will never embarrass you. إِنَّكَ لَتَسِلِ الرَّحِمِ وَتَحْمِلُ الْكَلِ وَتَكْسِبُ الْمَعْدُومِ وَتَعِينُ عَلَى نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِ. أو كما قال يا رسول الله, you help the poor. غریبوں کی مدد کرتے ہیں, رشتہ داروں کی مدد کرتے ہیں, مظلوموں کی مدد کرتے ہیں, اللہ تمہارے ساتھ ہے. The first person to give the Prophet support was Khadija. And Aisha is saying, I'm better? لا إله إلا الله. آمنت بي إِذْ كَفَرَ النَّاسِ. When people didn't believe in me. So brothers, this is Khadija who left this world. Can you imagine the pain of the Prophet ﷺ? So much. And Abu Talib dying without Islam was also very painful. For many days the Prophet was in gham, gham, gham. Okay, my uncle, my Sasha, Islam ki bighair marja. Gham, gham, gham. Gham. I don't know if you know anyone here who's your friend whose mother has died without Islam. But I know some people who converted. I know some people who converted and their mother has died without Islam. Every time they remember their mother, they cry. Until Allah revealed this ayah. إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Hidayat is not in your hands. Hidayat is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why we should all say Alhamdulillah. 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 Then the Prophet ﷺ goes to Taif looking for some help. And what happens in Taif? Everyone knows the Taif. 7 miles. How many? The people of Taif, the kids of Taif, Abdialim, the people of the children of Abdialim, the leaders, they threw stones at the Prophet ﷺ. How many? The greatest party. La ilaha illallah. The hair of the Prophet is more precious than the entire world. This head to the toe of the Prophet is bleeding in blood. Bleeding in blood. The malaika are out in the heavens are crying. What should we do? Ya Allah. فَقَدْ نَزَلَ جِبْرِيلِ. Al-Jibreel comes. Ya Rasulullah. مَعِيَ مَلَكُ الْجِبَالِ. With me are the angel of the mountains. إِنْ أَمَرْتَ أَنْ أُطْبِقَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَخْشَبَيْنِ. You tell us, we will crush the people of Taif. Just tell us. The Prophet is bleeding. His uncle has died. His wife has passed away. The people of Taif stoned him for seven miles. If someone tells us to leave a grocery store, we give him gali. If someone cuts us up in the car, we swear at him. If someone steps on my new shoes, I get angry. The Prophet is stoned for 7 miles bleeding. This is the Nabi of Allah. هو المصطفى هو المجتبى هو حبيب الله سراجا منيرا. The first one to knock on the door of Jannah is Rasulullah. He will come, آتي باب, I will come to the gates of Jannah and I will knock. فَيَقُولُ الْخَازِنُ مَنْ أَنْتَ. And the gatekeeper inside will say, man, who are you? Who is knocking on my door? The Jannah. For hundreds of years and thousands of years, no knock. No knock.
After thousands of years,
कोई खटखटा रहा हमारे दरवाजे को.
कौन है? मैं अंत.
فأقول أنا محمد. I will say this is Muhammad has arrived. خاتم النبيين has arrived. حبيب الله has arrived. The most beloved to Allah. فيقول الخازن بك أمرت أن لا أفتح لأحد قبلك. I have been ordered by Allah not to open the doors of Jannah till Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam arrived. Allah ka hukm diya gaya ke darwaza mat kholna jab tak darbar Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam Habibullah na. So brothers, can you imagine the blood on him and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? We're going to finish. The Prophet raises his hands. Allahumma inni ashku ilayka ba'sa quwwati wa qillata hilati wa hawani 'ala an-nas. He complains about himself. And then after this whole incident, there's one thing that takes place, and this is my conclusion. And this is after bleeding, after 9-10 years of pain, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is time that my Prophet gets a little break. Ab to thoda sa chutti honi chahiye mere Habib ki. Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdi. Allahu Akbar. Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdi. ليلا من المسجد الحرام الى المسجد الاقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من اياتنا انه هو السميع البصير. Now it's a little bit. Now the Prophet has gone through so much. Bring him for this journey from Makkah to Bayt al-Maqdis. والنجم اذا هوى ما ضل صاحبكم وما غوى وما ينطق عن الهوى ان هو الا وحي يوحى علمه شديد القوى ذو مرة فاستوى وهو بالأفق الأعلى ثم دنا فتجلى فكان قاب قوسين أو أدنى فأوحى إلى عبده ما أوحى ما كذب الفؤاد ما رأى أفتمارونه على ما يرى. To Bayt al-Maqdis, and then one by one, first sky, Adam, السلام عليكم, أهلا وسهلا, مرحبا بنبي الصالح وابن الصالح. First sky, Adam. Second sky, who is second sky? Who knows the second sky? Huh? Second sky, Isa and Harun. Isa and Yahya, second sky. Isa and Yahya. Salamu alaykum to Isa and Yahya, la ilaha illallah. Third sky, Idris. Fourth sky, Yusuf. Fifth sky, Harun. And Musa. Sixth sky, Musa. Seventh sky, Ibrahim, meaning all the prophets all the way to the skies. Then Jibreel says to the Prophet هَذِهِ السِّرَّةُ الْمُنْتَهَى. This is where I can stop and I cannot go ahead. Now it's you all the way to Allah. ثُمَّ دَنَا فَجَدَلَّ فَكَانَ قَابَ قَوْسَيْنِ أَوَدَنَا. Few weeks ago, he was bleeding in the streets of Taif, and here he is in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. چند ہفتے پہلے خون کے تلاب میں آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم گرے ہوئے تھے, اور آج آسمانوں میں ایک سفر کیا جا رہا ہے. اللہ اکبر. فَكَانَ قَابَ قَوْتْ ثُمَّ جَنَا فَتَتَلْ. قریب آؤ, قریب آؤ, اور آؤ, come closer, come closer, او حبیب. ثُمَّ جَنَا فَتَتَلْ فَكَانَ قَابَ قَوْسَنِي. Two bows away, 2 meters away, two stops. اللہ اکبر. فَكَانَ قَابَ قَوْسَنِي او جَنَا. And then the Prophet ﷺ comes back with this gift of salah. Gift of salah. Brothers, I conclude with you. Anytime you go through difficulty, 10 years or 5 days, the answer to our difficulty is salah. Why? Because after 10 years of difficulty, one was the journey to the heavens in the gift in return. Muhammad, you may come one time to me to the heavens, but now you go into sajda, you have touched my feet. إِذَا سَجَدَ أَحَدُكُمْ فَإِنَّمَا سَجَدَ عَلَىٰ قَدِمِ الرَّحْمَنِ. When anyone does sajda, they're doing sajda at the feet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You may not go to the skies, but your ancestors will be called as if you are at the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dua aise qubul hongi, jaise ke Rabbul Alameen ke darwaza pe aadmi khada hua. Ruhani mi'raj. Mi'rajul mu'min as-salah. So brothers and elders, we are very fortunate to be from this ummah. We have these children who became hafaz. We have this buzurg ulama from here, from overseas. We are very lucky, brothers and elders. We should be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever there is hardship, anytime, koi bhi parashani, koi bhi mushakkat, bibi nahi, friend nahi, koi nahi call my friend, I need kars kars. No, The call towards Allah is do, do, do. 2, 2, 2. 2 o'clock at night. 2 rakat salat. And 2 drops of tears. Allah will give you whatever you want. How much? 2, 2, 2. 2 o'clock at night. 2 rakat salat. And 2 drops of tears. You want to add 2 more? You can raise your 2 hands. Hat uthao. Yeah, this is your miraj. This is the miraj. Yehi mu'min ki miraj. Allah ke saamne girna. This is the miraj of a believer. So brothers and elders, we all have problems, don't we? Sabko parshani hai. Everyone's worried about their wife, my wife, your children, my business, my house, your parents, my parents. And musabbibul asbab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Amman yujibul muttarra ila da'a. Just raise your hand and Allah will not reject you. You are the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept us, to resurrect us on the Day of Judgment with Habibullah Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept these children who became hafiz. Qul ameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept their parents, to crown their parents of the crown of Jannah on the Day of Judgment. And all those who are becoming hafiz, mashallah. We have mashallah Hafiz Majdi became hafiz, Hafiz Mahfuz, and all these students who became hafiz. May Allah accept, may Allah put barakah. May Allah remove all the worries of the people in this community. Say ameen. We were the organizers for this beautiful program. And our buzurg who is visiting from overseas in Canada, may Allah put barakah in their life. And all the hazrat ulama who are here, give them long life with afi and barakah.